I'll do the talking. Let me do the talking. Whatever number they throw, don't anybody's eyes bug out.
No eye bugging.
We'll just play this easy.
Forget easy, Bobby. Let's hardline.
You don't hardline. It's about
playing. I'm trying to case just to drive it between our cheeks.
On condition of secrecy, signed confidentiality statements, no admission of liability, T.L. Michaels is prepared to offer $425,000, structured over 2 years.
That offer is rejected.
That offer is only being made because sometimes it's cheaper to shoo away a mosquito rather than to slap it dead.
Look, I'm not going to pretend that we measure up here on legal talent, but let's be honest. You wouldn't be making any settlement if you weren't anxious.
Anxious to avoid a protracted trial, that's all.
I understand, but we have taken away your defense. Your strategy of blaming the victim, gone. We already blamed her. Your scientific assault on nicotine being addictive, gone. We're not arguing addiction. Your medical, technical wizardry saying that cigarettes don't cause cancer, we want you to argue that one. You know, we might be crazy, but there's a climate out there right now. States are suing tobacco companies for health costs associated with smoking. We are taking the gamble that the public and those jurors, they already know that you're the bad guys. You've already lost one. Just a matter of time before a jury in Massachusetts is going to want to pinch you. And if we get them there to the point where they want you to feel a sting, even a little sting, imagine. $1 million is no pinch to you. 10 million. Isn't even a pimple. You rake in $76 million a day. A day. What if they think for killing Margaret Ray, you should forfeit just one day's proceeds? Or even half a day? And here's the biggest thing of all. Most victims don't bother to sue because you're just too big a windmill. What if you should ever lose a jury trial to a plaintiff who puts on so simple a case? 4 witnesses? No autopsy needed? We'd be profiled in every legal journal. Mike Wallace would be in my office, and plaintiffs would suddenly be coming out of the woodwork.
Well, you just have it all figured out, don't you?
No, Mr. Pearson, we don't. We're just guessing. I admit that, but suppose we guess right. Can you really afford to take that kind of chance?
Can you? With your contingency fee, you're turning down $150,000. Now, it's just a hunch, but I suspect you could use that money.
We reject your offer. Let's go.
Are you crazy?
$400,000? We were authorized to take anything over $3,000.
I was authorized to reject
it. All times, please, Mr.
Calhoun. Whatever, sir, now just stick it to it. I know what I'm doing.
Excuse me, but did you forget that we were broke?
It's called, we don't want to come out of here.
It's called, we don't want to come out of here.